So recently, we published a couple papers showing that different pathogens elicit unique innate immune signatures. So one pathogen will elicit a particular profile or signature, and then another pathogen, another profile or signature. And those signatures are important because some of them are detrimental to us as the host or the human. Ultimately, it would be important to understand these signatures so that we know if a human was more susceptible to another type of infection. And yes, we could potentially prevent that, inform that patient. Ultimately, it would be wonderful if we could modulate that signature and now make it less detrimental. And now we're protecting that host from a sexually transmitted infection, for example. So it's very interesting. Most of what we know about mucosal sites in general has been determined in the gastrointestinal tract, and more recently the respiratory tract. But the reproductive tract is kind of an understudied area. Specifically to what I study, I think that the community at large it needs to be educated a little bit more in terms of understanding that there are beneficial bacteria that help us and that are beneficial to our overall health and well-being. And I think that a lot of people just think bacteria equals bad, and that's not necessarily true. And that's what we're trying to understand in the female reproductive tract is which bacteria are good, which are bad, and which set you up for these signatures that can be detrimental. I was exposed to leaders in the field of women's health, and they really got me excited about the reproductive tract and preventing sexually transmitted infections. When I started out, I wanted to be a physician, and when I was an undergrad, I did some research to try to kind of bolster my CV for med school, and realized that I really loved research and changed my whole career path based on my mentor in my undergraduate in Colorado. And so if I didn't have that experience, once I started generating valuable data and started presenting that regionally and nationally, I got very excited, and I just want to kind of pay that forward. I like to train and mentor students at different stages, especially at the undergraduate level. If we didn't have research, we wouldn't make new discoveries, come up with new prevention strategies, vaccines, and those diseases that we're trying to prevent or ameliorate affect everyone in the community. So I think that's important. The most satisfaction I'd say is helping people get to that next stage in their career. So I really take mentoring seriously, and I love to mentor new students. I love to get those emails back that I got into graduate school, I got into med school or dental school, whatever their ultimate career path might be.